Good evening, race fans. Welcome back to another evening of Historic Trans Am Series racing. Gonna pop right over to the starting grid as the formation lap is making its way into the corkscrew, the famous corkscrew. Once again, first row, DAT Trashman, second Wagonator, Sierra XR8, Crafty Bunman, Flight in fifth, Schleprock sixth, Team Reedy seventh, Demon or One Big Man, Sia 2004, Anson San, 4KM T-Bird, Springa, Roland XCC, Sledlum, Optimizer, Gorilla Panic, 110 Octane, Rob Loves Cars, Patriot, and Demon Child back in 20th. Quick look at the track map as well, as they're getting close to getting to the final turn 11, pictured there, and we'll skip right over as they are going racing as we cross start finish line to start the first lap. And I have started my timer as well, so hopefully I don't screw it up like I did last week. We have, like I said, DAT Trashman, sorry, that Trashman and Wagonator running 1 and 2, both qualifying quite well in those Team Firebirds. Wow, that was a terrible camera view. Looks like they're pulling away as well on Sierra in that Challengers. Good qualifying this week by Sierra. Well done. Good to see you back up there in the mix. Behind him is Crafty Budman. Schleprock is in fifth currently. And again, the weird camera angles. But hey, whatever. We'll actually go back as Trashman and Wagonator go through the corkscrew. We'll pop back to fourth place with Crafty Budman. See what's going on back a little further in the pack. Usually it's where all this time during the race, it's where all the action tends to happen. As they come around into the final turn and about to complete the first lap. Seems like everything, at least up front, went off without a hitch. I don't see a whole lot going on. Probably some bumping and banging along the way, but that's usually par for the course with these big old lumbering beasts. Oh, Schleprock right on the back of Crafty Budman going into that corner. We'll pop back a little further to seventh with Flight, or Flight. As we got a bumper cam with him, hooray! One big man up ahead of him, and behind is Team Reedy, right on his, well, not right on his bumper, but close enough to make it a race. We'll pop back up to first and second again, as Trashman is still ahead of Wagonator. That is a brave pass, or brave attempt at a pass by Wagonator as they go side by side through the corkscrew. Wow. Wagonator still, well, he was on the inside, but he has fallen back behind Trashman again. Trashman goes a little wide, coming into turn 10. Definitely lost a little bit of ground on that attempt to pass through the corkscrew. Brave, but he ultimately paid for it. As Trashman heads into the turn two, which is the Andretti hairpin. Since Wagonator's fallen back a little bit, we will pop back a little further and see what Yan San San is doing back in 10th. And right behind him is 4KM T-Bird. Right in front of him, that I do believe is Sia 2004. Yes, as he goes off and loses three places to that. Dan Sansan currently running 10th, Springa 9th. Looks like Springa has a little bit of rear end damage there. Probably from turn one on the start. That during practice, that was quite hairy. There's lots going off there. As that was Roland taking an odd line through, probably an evasive line through the corkscrew. Lots of action here so far as they head on down into the final corner. Turn 11 again to back onto the start-finish straight to complete another lap. And speaking of laps, I am on the vitamin O again tonight. Cheers. As Jan Sansan looks up the inside of Springa, but there's no room. I think Jan Sansan was a little disappointed with that qualifying effort. Honestly, not sure if it's strategic or not, because he's got success ballast. And next week, we will be at Indianapolis road course, and definitely a high horsepower track. Half the track basically being the part of the banked oval and the front start straightaway. As they head up around turn 6 into Ray Hall Straight underneath the Pepsi sign. There it is, Pepsi sign. Looking at the wrong screen again. Down into the corkscrew. Alright, let's pop on back to 15th with 110 octane. Appears to be running by himself, and that is Demon Child, I do believe, behind him as well. Demon Child unfortunately missed qualifying, so he had to start from the rear. Pop up to 8th with Team Reedy in his Javelin. Actually, for anybody that doesn't know, I'm Canadian and I'm from the very, 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 very East Coast. My wife and I went on a vacation in through California and stuff, and we went to the Monterey Bay Aquarium for the day, and we were driving up north towards headed for San Francisco, and wasn't really thinking about it, just driving along the road, and I'm like, saw the sign, Mazda Laguna Seca. I'm like, having this big kind of geek out moment, and my wife's just kind of looking at me like, what's wrong with you? And I'm kind of like pointing and fumbling words as we drove past. I think she still I did end up going to Sonoma on that trip and seeing the historic Trans Am live there, and that was absolutely phenomenal. Anyway, enough of trip down memory lane, as we will head back on up to Crafty Budman in his 24 Camaro. Schleprock, I do believe, got past him. He did. Look at that. I think this Firebird seems to like this racetrack. It seems to work well. As we head on into turn 5 in the uphill. Big old climb up to turn 6. We will pop back up to first place, where Trashman is still ahead of Wagonator as they come through the corkscrew. Doesn't look like the Wagonator was close enough to try his move again through that corner. Looks like he's got a good run going on him going into the final corner. It's really close. Not sure if he'll get any sort of draft going down the start finish line. As they head into turn one, that little kink. Nice line by Trashman. A little wide for Wagonator. Sierra still hanging on back there. See him not too far off. Really good showing by Sierra so far. I think maybe his luck has finally turned around. He certainly deserves it. It's weird audio through that part where there isn't really any audio from the race. I don't know what's up with that. But hey, go get him turn 10. You're doing a great job. Cars look nice though. We shall pop on back to 7th with our flight. Aziz heading up the Ray Hall straight. With Team Reedy not far behind him. Ooh, a little squirrely coming out of the corkscrew. We're going to take just a brief moment here and pop on over to show the standings. Currently in tied for first, fighting Herd Diablo, who did not show up tonight, and Yan San San. Wagonator and Trashman not far behind, the Crafty Budman, Schleprock, and so on and so forth down. We haven't seen Toshiba or Matrix, Tie Sites, or Jackie Chan GT recently either, so they're going to be falling down after missing two races in a row now. They're going to be falling way down the standings. It's unfortunate. Big thank you again to Snap-on and our friends at SeasonGamers.com for hosting this series. As we pop over to Springa as he drifts around turn 5. And I do believe, yes, not the right line. That's going to cost him dearly as he loses 3-4 places there. And I think we must be into pit stop area, because Yan San San is back in 18th. Or did he have a major off? Front of his car looks a little wobbly. A little wonky. As he drifts through the corkscrew. Again, I'm not sure if this is strategic or not, but you'd think he'd want to be keeping some sort of points gain out of this. Not sure, like I say, if we're into pit stop territory, because we're only on lap 8 by my estimate, and it's a 21 lap race, so he could have possibly taken an early pit stop, but I don't know about that. As we are with Gorilla Panic, who is following Springa after Springa's off, so this is a battle for 11th. We'll be right back. pop on up to Sia 2004, who is currently running 10th. Cars are quite spread out now. The only close race is up front and the one between Springa and Gorilla Panic. So we will just pop on back up to the front and see how Trashman and Wagonator are making out. Trashman is still ahead of Wagonator, as they are currently on lap 9, according to my estimates. So we could be right in around pit stop time now, as it is a 21 lap race, so we're almost at halfway. A lot of dust blowing through that corner. And I know I've gone on this rant before, but the things that turn 10 spent their effort on and not on other things that you think would be better for us, the end user. Anyway, end rant. Crafty Budman is currently showing in third. I'm guessing that and Sears back in 10th, so I'm guessing that pit stops are starting to play out here. We are going on board, or not on board, but we are following One Big Man 43 and his challenger as he heads into the pits, followed by Team Reedy. And pit stops for everyone. We don't need to be following this, so we will go to Four Cam T-Bird, who is in the pits as well. Never mind. Everybody's pitting. Trashman and Wagonator have not. Crafty Budman have not. We'll pop onto that battle. Between turn 5 and 6, yet again. Or no, sorry, they're on the right hill straight. My apologies. Heading into the corkscrew. Heavy, heavy braking by Wagonator. I wonder if they're going to be pulling into the pits this lap. Let's stay on board and find out. Nope, they're going another lap. East. Things are definitely starting to sort themselves out. Showing Sierra back in third, followed by Schlepprock in fourth, Crafty Budman fifth, Roland XTC in sixth, RR Flights currently run seventh, One Big Man 43 currently running eighth, Team Radiant ninth, for Cam T-Bird currently running 10th. Yan San San back up 11th, so it was an early print stop by Yan San San. Unless he hasn't pitted yet either, which is possible. We'll pop over to Yan San San. Sia 2004 is currently 12th, Springa 13th, Gorilla Panic 14th, Demon Child 15th, Rob Loves Car is 16th, 110 Octane 17th, Patriot 18th, Optimizer 19th, and Sedlum. Oh, Sedlum has fallen way back. He's currently running 20th. Very unfortunate. Let's see if there's damage on Sedlum, or is it just that the pit stops still haven't completely played out? I don't know if he had an off. Or car looks okay from what I can see. He had a really good qualifying. I'm guessing it's either pit stops haven't played out or he had a major off somewhere. And as well, Optimizer. 17th. It's unusual for him. He does have some damage there, so he could have been, again, a turn one incident, as you know, that Andretti hairpin caught a lot of people out as he goes wide through the corkscrew. It's 110 right in front of him. Demon Child currently running 14, so he's gained some positions. Not too far off from Gorilla Panic in Springa. That Gorilla Panic Springa Sia little train that's going there. By my count, we are currently on lap 12. And looking like 13 now. Or about to be 13. Oh, yeah. Looks like possibly Patriot would be a lap down at this point behind them. Go back to 5th with Crafty Budman, who is following Schleprock. I don't know why the audio cuts out right at this point. It's kind of weird. And it finally comes back in. Fades out. They head on towards the corkscrew, turn 8 and 8A, as listed on the official track map. Sierra still holding on to third. He's got a good gap between him and Schleprock. Hop back to Team Reedy, 48. Looks like he's kind of running by himself at this point. That's 4cam off in the distance behind him that you can see. As he heads around turn 2. Again, you can see these helicopters flying overhead. I'd love if they actually hooked a camera to those. There is a quote-unquote helicopter view camera, but it's like just close up from right above the roof of the car. It's kind of shitty, actually. See ya, 2004. Currently running 11th. And Sam San has made up a spot on Sia. Of course we missed that because, you know, I'm shit. Dead air. my screen on my laptop went dark, so I had to log back in so I could get the track map. You'd think I'd have it memorized by this point, but you know what? It's 11 o'clock my time. I'm tired. I'm half drunk. Well, I'll blame it all on all the above. Gorilla Panic has fallen back to 14th. I don't think he was there. I think he was even further up before, it seems to me. Sedlam back in 17th now. Roland 18th. Rob Loeb's car was 19th. And Patriot in 20th. I'm not sure if we've gone to Rob Loeb's cars yet or no. We have not been on board with or followed Rob Loeb's cars yet. In his Nova. Little twitchy coming in there. That's obviously lag on my part. As he heads up the hill over turn one hill there. Awfully wide through turn two. Ahead of him is Roland XTC, who has mucho damage on the front of his car. He is following Sedlam. This is a race for 17th and 18th. That is heavy damage. And those are some tires. Hello, tires. Look. Ooh, somebody was definitely into the wall down at the bottom of the corkscrew. There we go. Seeing if anybody's out of position, so you're going to hear a lot of clicking. I don't see anybody that's really out of position. Maybe it was Roland that did that, by the amount of damage on his car. Either way, we will pop back up to first and second with Trashman still ahead of Wagonator. Currently on lap 16. Coming around the final corner on the start finish straightaway. And that would be lap 17. Not as much action as last week. Unfortunately, cars are definitely more spread out. Definitely a more technical track, this one, than Watkins Glen. Watkins Glen tends to be a little more wide open. Not as many, quite as many technical turns as this track, so I'll chalk it all up to the circuit that we're at. Trashman is pulling out a bit of a gap on Wagonator. And here's Sierra, who's still running third. Oh, as he goes very wide through the corkscrew, that is giving Schleprock an opportunity to sneak underneath. Possibly, no, he's going to stick in fourth, but he is a whole lot closer now. We will stick with this battle. Hooray, we've got a battle. Here we go, boys. As they come around the final corner, we have Crafty Budman in the mix as well back there. This is all a battle for third, fourth, and fifth. As they head down into turn two. Again, my multitasking is crap. As we head up the hill into turn six. Fun fact, since Schlepprock is running a Firebird at this point, here's a fun fact that's related to it. Though named after the race series, Pontiac's Trans Am Firebird has never realized its potential and has been a serious contender in the series. It's certainly not holding true for our Forza version of the series, because we've got, two out front currently, and one in fourth. And if memory serves me correct, Wagonator and Trashman are in third and fourth in the point standings currently as well. This is, if they bring it home one and two, this is certainly going to knock them up probably past Diablo, who has not raced tonight. Keep in mind, of course, there is drop week. VIR is being added to the series schedule since it's been released as DLC. So that's going to be added to the end of the series, and if somebody doesn't want to download or buy VIR, then that will be their drop week track. So, not sure if, well, Diablo already missed a race or two as well, so certainly end of drop weeks, to put it that way. Looks like Trashman and Wagonator are fighting it out again. Let's pop on up to... I missed that. They are coming up on lap traffic. That would be Rob Lowe's cars that they have lapped. Alright, we'll pop back to Sierra and that battle. Oh, Crafty Budman has made it past Schlepprock. Are these Drivatars? These are Drivatars, damn it. The race is over, hooray! These gotta be Drivatars. By my count, though, we're only on lap 20, but these are definitely Drivatars. Well, there you go. Another race over. We'll watch these Drivatars go for a little bit, I guess. Let them battle it out before the final results pop up. Again, thank you to Season Gamers, Snap-on, and Vitamin O for getting me a little wreck tonight. Speaking of wreck, look at those Drivatars go! Yeah, go Drivatars! Here's a fun fact that I learned. That I learned tonight. My Drivatar actually is a better racer than I am. Fun fact. I wish there was a better replay system on this as well. I would love to go back and be able to see what happened in the bottom of the corkscrew. Who messed up that nice tire wall? Track merch is going to be some pissed at you. In I'd be embarrassed if this actually wasn't the driving charge, because they're still going on. But it's still, yeah, these are definitely driver charges, because it's still showing Trash Man at first, even though he's been passed. What else? There we go. The screen has finally popped. We can go to the final standings and get this train wreck out of the way. And I can go the heck to bed. Well, after I finish my drink. Yeah, it's not doing too bad. No, I don't want to use that. I want to use this. Here we go. First, Trash Man. Second, Wagonator. Third, CRX-R8. Well done, Sierra. Nice to see you back up towards the top. Fourth, Crafty Budman. He did make the move on Schlepprock to get fourth. Schlepprock fifth. And sorry about missing that. I thought something else was going on up front, but it wasn't. Sixth, Flight 602. Seventh, One Big Man 43. Eighth, Team Rady 48. Ninth, 4Cam T-Bird. 10th, Yansan San. 11th, Sia 2004. 12th, Springa. 13th, Demon Child. 14th, Gorilla Panic. 15th, Optimizer. 16th, Sedlam. 17th, 110 Octane. 18th, Roland XDC. 19th, Rob Love Cars. And 20th, Patriot 01. So I think the big mover of the evening would probably be Demon Child. He didn't qualify, so he made it from 20th to 13th. Other than that, I honestly don't remember what the starting order was, other than Trashman, Wagonator. Yeah. Maybe I should have that for next time. Note to self. Again, great having you on board. Another great week of racing. We will see you next week. Again, that will be at Indianapolis Road Course. I'm quite sure the point standings will look a whole lot different than they are this week. And as always, I will leave you with the ad for our fine friends at GTR Live, who broadcast iRacing races live. They have a fun series on Monday nights where they call it Monday Night Mayhem, where they go down to the rookie class and broadcast rookie class races on oval, which are a fantastic train wreck, followed by the full Cuthbertson Challenge. The full Cuthbertson Challenge is named after a fellow that used to race on Forza and iRacing with us. He's moved on to, or moved back to RC car racing anyway. Basically, the premise is you go into the race without a setup, because that's what he'd do. He'd show up to a race and ask for a setup as the race is about to start. So this series, you go in without a setup, and you don't know what the track is, and you don't know what the car is, and it's go, you know, sort of this weird mix-up. You know, it could be street stock at Spa or something like that, something silly. Anyway, you get the idea. So they have those fun little things. And anyway, without further ado, here is their ad, and we will talk to you next week. Have a great one. Oh, wow.